Just checking texts and stuff. Okay, cool. Alright, so here we are, guys, jumping into map number 3. This is going to put someone into the lead. The score is tied, so it's not as important. You know, it's not the the decider, the ace match. Just someone to get the lead and, you know, put themselves on match point. But here we are, guys, jumping into this match. Spawning down here at the bottom right. He is currently teamless. Played fantastic the last game. Great build. It is going to be, of course, Ragnarok. And he is your red Zerg player for this series. His opponent. Is he going to 2x? Please let me do that. He is! Spawning up at the top left. Been absolutely playing spectacular recently this month. It's shocking to see, actually. He's been, like, proper fantastic. Playing for Team Liquid. Recently winning Gfinity G3 and many other online tournaments and cups. It is going to be, of course, Bunny. And what did he play the other... He played something recently which people didn't expect him to do so well in. I don't know why he's not playing in the Red Bull online cups. Because they're really good as well. They're really good. Now, is this Overlord going to spot it? Okay, so when he flying to this location. Like, yesterday, when Center did it, I think he put his, like, a little bit further off, like, around by here. Like, they go from anywhere from here to this spot to here. These are the core positions. If it's a Reaper, it can sometimes go anywhere on this location. But Bunny does have to be careful. The Overlord covers this perfectly. So if Bunny sends an SCV from this point on, no pull first. Oh, sorry, the pull was first, so it's not going to be as potent. So he went pull first game, second game hatch first, this game pull first. So maybe he's expecting 2x's, you know. But if it spots this SCV, that will tip him off. So just watch his vision. He sees it come from that point of view. He's like, wait, what? It shouldn't be there. He's going to take a gas geyser, though. You don't really take a gas... Okay, he's producing Zerglings, that's why. Okay, that is why. He could actually run past the... Okay, here come the boys as well. He's leaving just four of them. The boys should have been spotted leaving the base there. And how many is he leaving? He's leaving 5, 6 for the meal back at home. The Marines are going out this way. These Zerglings could just run all the way around, man. They could run all the way around. Oh, he has to be careful. This does get spotted. The bunkers haven't been produced yet, and there is no spine crawler or something in the main, so he's not going to bring that up and run it down. But he reunites with his SCVs, and he has all of them in one go before building a bunker, so it makes it that much easier to build a bunker. But of course, it buys more time for the Zerg to get that more units to defend. Okay, so we have 4 Marines, 5 Marines. The Queen outranges a lot of these. He is going to get the SCV, even though the SCV was repairing it. And this is like a very, very methodic 2-rex bunker rush. This is very old school style. You don't see it too often. The choke could be forced there, but no, he just tries to microwave. A lot of Zerglings trying to get the surround on the Marines. There's still 5 of them left. 4 SCVs, 3 SCVs, 1. And the bunker only has a couple of hit points left, but there are no SCVs out on the map anymore. And Bunny is going to start producing SCVs yet again. So I feel like this has failed for now, and Bunny, he's in a tough position right now. He gets the cancel. It's only, you know, like 75 resources at this point in time. It's actually a big amount. Another SCV is moving out to move down onto the low ground. Okay, so he's going to try and play this out standard. Against Symbol, he failed. Yeah, sorry. I guess he's going to go for the 3 CC style. I think so. That's what he done against Symbol when it kind of failed. He didn't beat him in the early stages. He is going to get an Overlord. That supply caps him, forcing him to build an extra one instead. So, you know, that's going to hurt. But yeah, he went for 3 CC and kind of macroed up behind him, played standard. Like, he done the 2-rex and it wasn't that much damage dealt. And yeah, he just played standard and he managed to win. So there's the third command center. Like center, if anyone remembered center, like so you can see a comparison between games. Senta went for 2 wrecks, it kind of failed, and then he went for about 10 to like 15 marines, and that was against Ragnarok as well. He actually, like, he went for like 4 Turaxes, or like 3 Turaxes against them yesterday. But I like that he's taking out these rocks, that way if anything comes from here, or if some sort of contain comes from this point, and this isn't spotted, he can easily do a big zergling counterattack or run by. Orbital's getting morphed in, the roach is getting added on. No Evo chambers just yet, and we do have 2 gas geysers of the 2 hatcheries. So that's 41 workers v 18. Holy Jesus, it's going to be hard. It's going to be very hard to come back from. Like, there's so many worker differences. The Zerglings are coming up here. No Zergling speed or anything like that. First gas goes into the lair, which is nice. You know, like I said, if he gets the roach speed or something like that, he can get it as fast as possible. The Nidus, I don't think so. Especially now that I see the third does get dropped. So, I think a Muta build, maybe? So, you know, Limblin Muta, something to that extent. But the Reactor Hellion is in production, and we do have a Tech Lab getting added on by Liquid Bunny onto that Rex. I think maybe a, instead of, like, you can do the big Marine build that, like, Centadil did after a failed 2 Rex. Maybe a 2 factory with Blue Flame Hellion. You know, like, you know, the 14 to 16 Hellion time in that you do. I think that could work. I really think, because you're not going to see many roaches that early. So, you know, one more command center into that, I think could really do it. But we do have the Roach Warren completed. No upgrades coming out of it just yet. It should start in a moment. There it is. And we do have the 1-1 with a missile attack. So, Hydro Roach composition incoming from the Zerg player. Mainly, you know, based around roaches. Lots of roaches. But a supply cap here for Bunny. 54 supply V90. Still playing. You know, I love how he hasn't given up on this. He hasn't gone for an all-in. He's gonna try and macro up. Oh, wow. Just got another donation. Thank you, Andreas. Okay. So yeah, the Hellions, he hasn't spotted the 30, he hasn't seen this, he hasn't seen the 4 gas geysers, or the double Evo, or even the Roach ones. He has absolutely no freaking clue what's happening. Right now, the Overseer flies overhead, sees absolutely everything on the other side, so Ragnarok is perfectly in the clear. And on the other side, of course, right now, Bunny's going to be kind of a little bit scared. Still only 40 supply difference, you know, the meals make a huge difference. Okay, so what are we waiting for right now? It just seems like a lot of macro stuff happening. Is that? No, it's not a second starport. I thought that was a second starport. He's heading on a tech lab to the factory. Because, you know, I love the new compositions for Terran and TVZ, how it goes, it kind of goes bio into bio mine into bio mine Thor, with sometimes some sprinkled Hellions, or at least, you know, the Hellions lead into that. But the bio mine Thor is an absolutely top-notch composite. It's so good. And the new Thor buff, it's not technically a buff, it's just an AI change, but it makes such a phenomenal difference. But this is a lot of roaches. The tank are not in production just yet. The supply block is stopping it being produced, and everything else, he's got to start dropping these depots immediately right now. And this is actually a lot of units coming up to knock on the front door. It's nearly 40 roaches. The bunker is not going to be lasting long against one volley of those. And the SUVs get pulled. The boys are suiciding into the balls of acid that come from the roaches. And I think that might be GG, as Ragnarok does break the front.